everybody. This is Cindy Utter. Welcome to my artsy endeavors. Have fun. Hi, everybody. Cindy Utter here with my artsy endeavors. You're saying, what is that mess? Guess what time it is? It's time for our monthly challenge. Now, I have to thank my good friend, Carla. We got talking last night about my monthly challenge, and we came up with this really cool idea. What I've got here is, this is just a paper tablecloth, okay? I am going to be using some of this, so you know what, while I've got it out, find my scissors. Just going to cut a piece of this off. Now I found this at, I think it was at a thrift store. I know it was really cheap. I didn't pay hardly anything for it, but it's just a paper tablecloth. So let's set that aside. So we've got this here. All right. I've got some muslin here. I got this at the World Market. It's just twine. I've got that. I have some laces. I have some other fibers here. I've got a few blingy things. I also have, here to the side, I have a little bag of purple buttons. I couldn't believe when I found these purple buttons. And they have another set that's darker, so I might have to go back and get those. And then we have cupcake liners. Now, these cupcake liners, I think I got at either a Joann's or a Michael's. I'm not sure. But I love the colors. So what we're going to do today with all of these different goodies is, because we're bringing in May, and normally April showers bring May flowers, what we're going to do is we're going to make flowers with all of these different textures and items. So what my challenge is for you this month is, I want you to think non-traditionally on making flowers, you know, not just painted papers or, the Tyvek flowers that we just did this last month, but just, I want you to make some flowers out of other things that you have in your stash. So look at your stash a little bit differently. I'd like to make some of this twine into flowers. It's going to be interesting. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to share with you this process. I also have this here, which I think is really pretty. I found this also somewhere at a thrift store, or maybe a Michael's or Joann's for a buck, and I thought that was really pretty, so I picked that up. And then the cupcake holders. Now, I'll show you how to make these. They're really easy and simple. They'd be something great to do with your grandchildren, if you have grandchildren, or your children if they're younger. They would really have fun doing these. They're a lot of fun. So this is the cupcake liners. There's a couple of them. And then this is the very first one I made, and I thought, oh, that's really cool. It's a great big button. I cut down the liners, and then what I had cut off, which were like these strips here, I had just glued down into different pieces to give it those different layers. And actually, I think this one needs to go in there. See? So, and I just used a little bit of tacky glue. Now, this is just a front flower. It's not really a back flower because the backs aren't colored. So there's one. And then here's another one. I was just playing with this and I wanted to see what I could do. And here's another little flower. And just by doing what I'm doing right here, I just got another really cool idea. So this one, like I said, I just stuck down some of these pretty buttons in the middle. And it's just made with a main cupcake liner, which I cut down, and then I used the cutoff in the inside of the liners. Okay, so there's the paper, the cupcake flowers. I will make one really quick to show you how I did it. I'm gonna make another one of these because this is really cool. I gotta get you guys out a little bit more. There we go. Now you see my whole mess around me, so don't mind my mess. All right, so I'm going to make another one of these. So the first thing I do is I find whatever button I want. And I like that button. That works. Get out my tacky glue, which I know I have sitting right here. There's my tacky glue. And we've got our scissors. So the first thing I do is I take, where's my cupcake? Here, there. Let's get some blue. All right, I take one of the cupcake liners, and first thing I do is I cut it in half. I'm not precise about it, it doesn't matter. Then I cut it in half again and cut off the tip. Cut it in half again, cut off the tip, cut off the tip. All right, so here's some other ones that I already have done. Now I don't have, I want to do another colorful one. So let's take this one. And I don't know why, I saw these in the store and I thought, oh my gosh, we gotta be able to use those for something. So I'm gonna cut it in half again, cut off the tip, cut off the tip. Cut it in half again, tip and tip. Now the reason I'm cutting off the tip is because if you don't, you end up with a lot of stuff to glue. So what I do is I take my tacky glue, I take any of them, it doesn't matter which one, and I just put a little glue here because I want it to stick together on itself like that. Okay, so I put a little glue in there, put a little glue on the tip, and stick it to the button, right? Really simple, okay? So now I'm gonna pick another one, same thing, a little glue in so it sticks to itself, together to itself. I'll put a little glue on the tip and we're gonna stick it together. All right, so we're gonna continue this the whole way around. I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward through it and I'll be right back. Okay, so I have petals on the whole flower, right? Those are cute. You can do them shorter, you can do them smaller, you can do them skinnier, you can do them wider, however you want to do them. Now the back side is where all of these are stuck together. So what I'm gonna do is find another button. Doesn't really matter, it doesn't have to match the first one. And I'm just gonna glue a button to the back of the flower. So now we have a flower. Get the extra glue off this button. We have a flower that we can use either this way or this way. All right. So that's how to make this cupcake flower. Now I am going to show you really quick how I made the other one. All right. So there's those cupcake flowers. Now these, I'm going to show you really quick. This one, I'm not too sure I like that, but that's okay. All right, I'm going to show you real quick. What I do is I'm going to take a main color. This time I'm going to take yellow. All right, here's my big cupcake. And I'm just going to kind of smooth it out so it's kind of like square. See that? Move these out of the way. And here's some actual other cupcake liners that I have sitting here. So I might use these. So I've got my yellow. I'm going to take this blue and I'm just going to cut it down. Now, it doesn't have to be perfect. If it's, what flower do you know of that's perfect? None. No flower's perfect. So, oops, wrong way. Sorry about that. We're doing it this way. I want the color on my flowers. So, I'm just going to start layering until I see something I like, which I want pink. I'm going to take a pink one. And what's fantastic about these cupcake flowers is, oh my gosh, You could use, there's so many different designs out there. Can you imagine how many we could get? How many different styles of flowers you could make? It's crazy. Now this one I'm cutting off quite short because as I get toward the middle, I want it a little bit shorter. And see, I cut it off funky, that's okay. I'm gonna put that one right there. This one's gonna be built a little bit differently because I want different things to show. So now I can take this. All right, let's start gluing this together and let's build ourselves a flower. So we're gonna do this one. I just throw some glue down. There we go. Make sure it's glued. This one I think I'm gonna put down next. Put some glue down. All right, this pink one. Now I want some of this here to show, so I'm just gonna kinda set it off to the side a little bit. That's okay. Now I wanna take some of this and we're gonna start putting it down into here. So I'm just gonna throw some glue here to get it started. Okay. And then as I want to add it, just throw a little glue in there. Okay, these are really big flowers. Now, what I'd like to do, and I haven't had a chance to get back to the store to do it, is I want to try some really small cupcake liners. I think they would be fun too. So this one, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna glue just a little bit. You don't need a whole lot. You know, you don't have to douse them. See, that's enough glue. You don't have to really douse them with glue. This one I'm gonna stick in between these. See? And you just build them. Build on them until you get a shape or a color scheme that you really like. Now, I'm really not liking this entire yellow on the outside, so we're gonna put some pink down. And let's throw the pink right here. Okay. Perfect. This one's gonna be a big one. This one is going to be a big flower. All right, I'm gonna take, let's take some smaller. I haven't done this yet, so let's try it, see what it looks like. Worst we'll say is ew. I'm just gonna put a little bit of glue on it. And let's just kind of, let's see if this will work. I don't know if this will work or not. No, I don't like that. All right, so we didn't like that. So those can go over here. All right, what have we got here? We've got a little bit of purple. I want something, we need more yellow down in here, I think. So let's take yellow, throw some glue on it. I want some more yellow in here. And like I said, these are just, they're so forgiving and you can just do whatever you want with these. They don't have to be perfect. That's what I love about it. Somebody's talking to me. Hold on. Okay. Let's see. That's a, that's one of my hairs. Sorry about that, guys. All right. Oops, wrong way. Let's put this right here. Let's put it on the outside. Okay. All right, so now I've got kind of like a crazy bowl, right? And oops, I won't shut that. So now what I'm going to do is instead of buttons, remember this jar I showed you guys of all the goodies? Let's see what we can find in here. Nah, that makes it really heavy, but that's cool. Let's see what we can find. Where's the black ones? Could do a black. All right, I gotta shut my phone off. Hold on. Sorry about that, guys. Let's see. I don't know that I have anything in here big enough other than. Aha. All right, I am going to use that, but I'm still going to build around it. So let's take, I'm going to take this. This is a checker piece that I got in that jar of goodies. That is a great jar of goodies. And let me, I'm going to glue this. Because what I want to do is I'm going to make a small, like, petal. Like, I don't know what you want to call it, seed pod thing in the middle. Come on, stick. Oh, hold on. Sorry, Chase. No, I apologize, guys. Hold on. Okay, Chaser stopped barking. I don't know what was outside, but he was after something. So what I did is I put a couple sequin stars in there, and I finished gluing it together. But what I'd like to do, and I just can't do it right now because I don't have the stuff with me, is I'd like to spray it with a spray glue and add some seed beads to it. And I think it'd be really pretty. So I will probably do that once I get home. So that's how I've been making my cupcake flowers, just to play. All right, so here they are. And then there's three that have the regular buttons. Okay, so there's those. I'm gonna put this one on top. Now, the other thing I wanted to do is I want to make some flowers. Let me just get rid of some of this junk sitting here. I want to do some flowers out of lace, and I think they'd be really pretty. Now, I don't have a lot of lace with me. I only have a couple bits and pieces here, but I think they would be fun to do, like this here. I just think that'd be really fun to play with. So what I'm going to do, and I haven't done one of these, so I have no idea if this is even going to turn out or not. So let me just look and see what else is in here. Is there other lace? No, not really. No, but you know what? We have a couple little pieces of fabric we might use. Let's see what we can do. So like I said, I haven't done this yet, but I have an idea of how I want it to go. So here's a button. All right, here's my thought. I'm going to take this. Oh, I was just second thought it. We're going to round this a little bit. All right, this is going to be that. And then I'm going to take my lace. Like I said, I have not done this, so I don't even know if this is going to work. But we're going to try it. I'm going to take my glue, and I'm going to just put glue on here. Sit that right there. Then I'm going to take my lace. And hopefully make a little flower. I have no idea where that... I have a... Okay. So, need a little bit more glue in there. And this was my thought, just to make a little small flower. Now, I could have used a smaller button. This is kind of cute, isn't it? I could have used a smaller button, but I didn't. I like it just the way it is. Except for this piece is not glued down. So that's kind of cute. It's a cute flower, so let's make another one. Let's take another button. And I'm just going to cut this fabric. It's not perfect. Doesn't have to be. Here's my button. And I'm going to do the same thing with this lace. This lace? No, this lace. This is an elastic lace, which is cool. All right, so let's take this. I'm going to glue it. I'm going to sit it down. And I'm going to do the same thing. Just going to put that up under there. Maybe. Come on, go under there. See, like I said, I haven't made these, so I haven't quite got it down yet. But I like the idea. So it's going to work, darn it. It has to work. See, this one's smaller, so this one's a little bit more difficult. And maybe if I had a different lace, but that one's really small. So let's, apparently the bigger one works better. Let's try it again. Because this has got glue all over it now, so. You know what? I'm just going to leave it right here. Let's do this. Let's make it on the back of the fabric. Why not? Because we can, right? That's what mixed media art is all about. We do it however we want to do it. And I'm having fun, so that's all that matters. Now this I probably could have done on a smaller button. But you know what? Let's take this button. Let's put it right there. All right. That looks like a funky flower. It's got glue all over my buttons. Which we'll pick that off. Now that's a different one. The lace didn't come up as far as I'd like it to. Not thrilled with that one. All right, I really like this one. This one's cute. So let's do another one. Why not? I'm going to make a circle again. I love little pieces of fabric like this. I really do. They're so cool. All right, so we're going to take that. Let's try something else. Let's take, for some reason I have to have a button. Let's try a different lace for the heck of it. I'm thinking. Hold on a second, let me think. Okay guys, so here we go. I ended up with these three flowers. Am I absolutely thrilled with them? No, but they're cute. They're different, right? So there's another idea, unconventional, not unconventional, just an idea, all right? Now, I have one other idea here, and I still want to work with that, but this, what I did is I took, I have a bunch of pieces of little fabric with me, so I took the little pieces of fabric, and this is some muslin that I had with me, and I just cut it in random circles. So now what I want to do, of course, we have to get out the buttons. Buttons are just a staple, I think, in pretty much anything. But anyways, what I'm going to do, let me move this. This is annoying me. I don't spill my coffee. Things are getting in the way. We will use this, I promise. I just need stuff to get out of my way for right now. Okay. So we have those and these. Now, there we go. Now what I want to do with these, again, these are not going to be your conventional flowers. I just want something different. So what I plan to do is just kind of put stuff together here that's going to look like a little flower. Here, let's just start doing it. That's the easiest way to do things, is just do it. So there's one. Let's see, we got a bigger one here. There's one. Let's throw this down. And then I'm going to put a little bitty button. Boop. Cute. Now, if I was home, I would take some, you know, little, I actually might have some gel crayons with me, and let's see what we can do to those. But for right now, I'm just going to put them together. We're going to use this one with this. And let's take this. And, you know, I know the purple doesn't really go, but it's all going to tie together. You'll see. There's another little. So there's a cute little flower. Here's a cute little flower. Take this one. Let's put this on this one because that one's too small. And here's a couple bigger ones. Don't be surprised if Chase starts barking again. I hear something outside. So he might be start going spastic on me again. And then I'm going to take a little button. And there we go. All right. What do you see, buddy? He's heading toward the window. Button. Let's put this little guy here. I don't know, that blue just kind of got lost, but that's okay. And then we're going to put a little purple. Oh, we got the yard guy here. That's what he sees. So aren't they cute? You know, I thought, what the heck? Let's just make things with what you got. So really, this is the challenge. I want you to take things that you have in your studio or near you or whatever, just make some flowers. Chase, no. Chase, no. No. He's such a good boy. He's a Papillon, and he keeps me a lot of company. It's my friend's dog. It's not mine. Be a good boy. All right, so there's another little flower, and we'll finish these up. Let's put this down. This one's just going to have two and a button. Perfect. And this one is going to have, I'm going to cut this a little bit smaller. Well, it doesn't matter that it's not perfect. I don't care. No flower is perfect. And I'm sure as heck I'm not perfect. So I'm going to put that one right there. I have one little piece left over. Okay, so there is another set of flowers. Pretty cool, huh? All right, let me get the fibers and figure out what I'm gonna use for a base, and we're gonna make a few more flowers, then we're gonna put it all together. I'll be right back. All right, guys, well, apparently the mowers are here, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fast forward through this one so you guys don't have to listen to the lawnmowers. Hear them? I'm so sorry. Okay, what I'm going to do is fast forward. Now, what I've got is just some gauze here and a bunch of fibers. So let's play and see what we can come up with. guys, so here we go. Here is our challenge for the month of May. I want you to think outside the box and make some flowers. Now what I'm gonna do, like I said, this is just with the supplies that I have here with me. When I get back home, I'm gonna do some more embellishing to some of these. You know, I'll probably end up putting some glitter on these, that kind of stuff. Actually, I have glitter pens right here, but anyways. So now what I'm gonna do, now that we've made them, and I know you guys are all saying, well, you stuck those on those cardboard. Yes, I did. I put the gauze on this cardboard because I wanted it to have a more solid of a back to it. So what I'll do is I'll just cut around these and I'll use these flowers. I think these are cute. I like the way they turned out. So what I'm gonna do now is, that is the challenge, but what I'm gonna do is, I've got a little art journal here. I'm gonna play around with these flowers and make an art journal page. I'm gonna fast forward through it, but I hope you guys enjoy. We'll chat in a bit.
Thank you. Thank you.
just been having fun sitting here playing. Is this the greatest page I've ever done? Absolutely not. Am I in love with it? Eh. But you know what? I had a lot of fun. So I had fun playing with, you know, the flowers that I made, and just, I'm just enjoying, just relaxing and having fun with it. And you know, really, that's all the art is about, is the process of having fun. So I hope you guys have a lot of fun on this month's prompt. And like I said, you know, look for unconventional ways to make some flowers. Use some different supplies. Dig around in your stash and see what you've got that you can make into flowers. And I would love to, love, love to see what you come up with. So definitely share on my Artsy Endeavor page, okay? All right, I hope you guys have a wonderful day. As always, it's been a lot of fun, and we'll chat with you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye. Hey, everybody. I hope you enjoyed that video. As always, hit like, share, comment. I'll answer any of the comments that you have or questions. And as always, be kind, have fun. That's what life's all about. And happy creating. We'll talk to you soon. Bye.